In the previous examples, we were looking at our data, age and friend count, across the categorical variable, gender. Usually color or shape tend to be aesthetics for representing such changes over a categorical variable. But what if we looked at age and friend count over, say, another numerical variable? For example, we might notice that since users are likely to accumulate friends over their time using Facebook, that Facebook tenure is important for predicting friend count. Tenure, or how many days since registering with Facebook, is associated with age. The first people to start using Facebook were college students as of 2004 and 2005. I was lucky enough to be part of that group and join the site on February 3rd, 2005. As a result, I've amassed more friends over time and have over 1,200 of them. On the other hand, 14-year-old users have had less time to accumulate the same number of friends. One way to explore all four variables, friend count, age, gender, and tenure, is using a two-dimensional display like a scatter plot, and we can bin one of the quantitative variables and compare those bins. In this case, we can group users by the year that they joined. So let's create a new variable called year joined in our data frame. This variable is going to hold the year that our users first joined Facebook. In this next programming exercise, you're going to create this variable, year joined, and put it inside the data frame. You need to make use of the variable tenure and use 2014 as the reference year.